Let us talk about three-stage ripple counter. This will be a counter of three stage. We'll see the waveforms, how it is made, and we'll use this JK flip flop. And this is connected in the toggle mode, means 1 and 1 is given to J and K. And we'll create a binary counter system. So we'll start with the 1 JK flip flop. We'll apply a clock waveform and sketch this output QA. Now let us assume that pre and CLR, that preset and clear, has been disabled on all the flip flops. Now this will be negative edge triggered. So this is input. This is the input which is given. The waveform will be like this, pulsated. Okay. The QA will toggle on each negative edge of the input clock. At each negative edge, this QA is going to toggle. This is what we learned about JK flip flop. So this is the falling edge, this is the falling edge, this all are the falling edge, and only the let us assume that QA is 0 first. QA will toggle, means change its basically transition is taking place. So from 0 to 1 and 1 to 0 will take place only on these falling edges of the input clock, right? QA is like this. Let us connect our second stage to output QA. Okay, this is again a flip-flop. This is QA, which has been given as a as an input to the second flip-flop. Same thing will happen. Now QB, because QB is not related to input anymore, QB is only related to QA. So QB is going to change while QA is changing. So at all falling edges of QA, which is marked in red, falling, these are the arrows downwards, these arrow will toggle the output QB. So only the transition will take place here, here, here and here. Okay, now connect the third stage to output QB. Let us have this third flip-flop and JK flip-flop, and this is the QB. The output of QB is given to the input or the clock as a clock to this third flip-flop. Now again the same reasoning will take place. The falling edge of QB will trigger QC transition or toggling. Okay, QC will toggle on each negative edge of QB. So this falling edge, which is shown in green, only will trigger this toggling. Okay, this will be the toggle. Now label the input clock pulses from 0 to 7 and place the counter response in a table. Let us make a table for this. This is 0, this is 1, this is 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay, let us write the outputs in the form of table. This is 0, 0, 0. This is QC. I'm writing 0 here because this is 0. This is QB, this is 0, and this is 0. Okay, then we have 0, 0, 1 that I mentioned here. Then we have 0, 1, 0 again. Then we have 0, 1, 1 again as 3. Then 1, 0, 0. Then 1, 0, 1. So all this value, whatever we received here, are been displayed on this table. So this is how counter work. This is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And the table is the count of the state table. The counter is actually the mod 8 counter because it has 8 different count state. After that, this will again go to 0, 0, 0. The counter restarts at 0, 0 after this. So mod is actually the short form of modulus. This is modulus 8 counter. Then if you connect the flip-flop output to 3 LEDs, you will see a binary count sequence from 0 to 7 like this. Okay, first this, see these are the blinking, this next, again this, and finally the speed at which this counter counts is actually controlled by the input clock. 1 pps, that is 1 pulse per second input clock, will display 0 to 7 count sequence on the LEDs in 8 seconds. So each count state would last for 1 second. So if the clock input was 1000 pps, then all three LEDs would appear to be constantly on the same time. So the count cycle would take 8 milliseconds. So too fast to be visible on the three LEDs. Okay. So thank you so much. Hope you understood this three-stage ripple counter.